I think, you know, one of the things I really like about the Go Pulse site, for example, is that it provides a lot of information. I really take my hat off to the guys over there. I think they've done an excellent job of summarizing a lot of the information that's available about PulseChain. And one particular one that I like is the one that sort of monitors the, just the transaction costs. What are the various transaction costs and how much better is it with PulseChain relative to so many other layer ones and layer twos? Now, we all know that PulseChain was intended to be a cheaper version of Ethereum, as in cheaper to transact. It's not the only benefits, but I think personally, I believe it's one of the major benefits is being able to transact on a chain that in a very inexpensive way when compared to something like Ethereum. And I would suggest that a lot of projects on Ethereum have actually been throttled by some of the gas costs that exist over there. So, you know, and I personally, obviously we've forked the Liquidy project. I am a participant in the Liquidy project, and I've noticed, for example, that, you know, some of the earnings that may accumulate over there on Liquidy, for example, gets gobbled up very quickly by Ethereum gas fees. And none of us are surprised by what's happened with HEX. So HEX is the same situation over there, that, you know, whenever you stake your HEX and do anything that traditionally you would want to do with HEX on Ethereum, just the process of staking and then fundamentally unstaking at a certain point in time, the gas costs just completely cripple any potential benefits that you have. And so it's kind of frustrating that hasn't been addressed. And I think that's to the detriment of Ethereum. So the only activity personally I tend to see over there is the fact that people just buy something and hang on to it. And unless it's actually adding value, and I believe DeFi is a space that provides a lot of value, unless it's adding value, then it's kind of like just a speculative play. All you're hoping for is that you buy something and hope that it's going to increase in price for some particular reason. And that's, you know, that's the end of the story. Whereas my view is, hey, it's really good to have access to some of the DeFi projects and do so in a way that allows you to continue to accumulate wealth over time, but doesn't actually cripple you at the end of the day when you do want to unstake or do want to withdraw funds from a DeFi protocol. So, and I believe that that's where PulseChain, shines by comparison. And so if you go to the Go PulseChain site, you'll notice that there's a lot of content like that. So it's well worth reviewing some of that. And that's my view, that really we should be promoting and promoting the benefits of PulseChain to people outside the community. And certainly we're going to be doing our bit. Now, one example of that, and that's, you know, you may have seen Zone 5. So Ben Armstrong and Cassie have actually started to provide some content specific to PulseChain, which, you know, we're very much in support of. You may have noticed that Liquid Lines has decided to sponsor this particular channel, and mostly because we believe in the need to actually have a broader audience come in and understand PulseChain. And I think Ben and his team does an excellent job of breaking these things down. And I think RG3 and KDP have been on the channel just, you know, the first couple of episodes. And, you know, what I recall there is that, you know, they're very transparent in their views. And I think Ben is actually really doing a very good job of making sure that the broader community or communities outside of our existing community hopefully start to get to see and understand more about PulseChain. So big supporters of that, very happy with how that's progressing. Obviously, you know, it's really good to see, for example, I think there's a number of conferences around the globe. I think Token 2049 is a Dubai event. Fantastic bit of marketing here, but we actually have the highest of stakes appearing on the screens on the Emirates flights flying over there. So I think that's fantastic, right? So it automatically provides an audience that may not be familiar with PulseChain an opportunity to understand some of what makes Richard tick, and more importantly, hopefully that they start to understand a little bit more about us. And the other thing is it's a different audience, guys, right? So we are talking about folks that potentially have a higher disposable income. You know, if you're traveling the globe, generally speaking, you have the wherewithal to be able to do that. And also you have the wherewithal to potentially invest on in crypto and more importantly on blockchains like PulseChain. So from our point of view, it is really important. It's a really good piece of marketing. You know, we're really impressed by that. The other thing that I wanted to flag, and this is more a broader issue, and that is, you know, there's been a lot of negativity around Uniswap just of late. I don't have a strong opinion, but what I have noticed is, you know, all of a sudden we've got increases of fees, and that seems to happen on a whim, and it's a significant increase in terms of the transaction costs. So you kind of wonder, well, what's going on here? Why are costs escalating the way they are? What is driving? Is it a greed issue? Is there something else that's happening that may be actually, again, creating situations like this to try and reduce the benefit of using blockchain? But it also suggests, okay, maybe there's a better way to do this. And I know there's a number of DEXs on PulseChain, really good DEXs. There's aggregators on PulseChain. All of them are actually working really well, as far as I can tell. I mean, certainly I've played around with a number of them. And I just feel that the environment that we have is a much more transparent one on PulseChain than it is on some of the other chains. And I think Uniswap is just an example of that. I guess the other thing that I wanted to sort of point out is, you know, it's not necessarily a rant, but I don't want it to sound like a rant, but really, guys, I think if we take a look at how much is actually coming into PulseChain via the bridge, and particularly if you focus on the amount of DAI, for example, that's coming through, you'll notice that it's significantly reducing. Now, that's not a good sign, right? We really need to have more people come on to the chain. And I think it's highly correlated, incidentally, with what happens with the price of PulseChain. So if people are wanting to monitor that, that's a good avenue to look at. But again, my sense of all of this at the moment is we need to do everything we can to ensure that people get the message about what the benefits are of PulseChain. If we do that, we'll attract more to the chain. If we become a little bit too insular and start bickering amongst ourselves, I think that's a deterrent, right? So people aren't going to want to come to PulseChain. It's a problem. I think the other is that, you know, people need to see a little bit more positive marketing rather than the outrage marketing. I also think, you know, we should be focusing outside of the tent rather than inside the tent. And the more that we do that, the more people will want to listen and understand. And I think the better we sell the benefits of PulseChain to those that aren't currently in PulseChain, I think that bodes well for all projects that exist on the chain itself. So anyway, we're doing our little bit. I think, you know, obviously the work with Ben Armstrong and Cassie, that's part of the process that we're looking at. We are looking at other ways to entice people onto the chain. There'll be some announcements come through in the future on that. But on that note, guys, look, I just wanted to say there's a lot of activity out there at the moment. I think we need to focus on the positive. We need to be more engaging with other communities. It was really good to see the adverts on the Emirates flights. I think that's a fantastic piece of marketing. But we need to do more of that. We need to do more of that, more outreach, make sure that we can actually communicate effectively with communities outside of our existing one. And that will help the PulseChain community to grow. And on that note, guys, all the very best. Enjoy the rest of your week, and we'll catch up with you soon.